Well, now let's take a look at what we've done here. As you can see, I've cleaned most of this up right around the neck. Basically, what I did was I brushed it all out with my clone stamp tool, and of course, I used a lot of. I brought my clone stamp tool opacity down to 25% to kind of clean up a little bit in here. It's still kind of ugly compared to the normal picture. We'll take a comparative of the two. But as you can see, we're moving right along, and we'll hold here for right now. So what we're going to do now is let's go ahead and get rid of this arm and try to get rid of some of this going on in here. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and hit our, go ahead and go back to my clone stamp tool. Let's get on to the right layer, of course. I don't have the right layer chosen. Choose the right layer. Come down here. I'll choose my object path here. I'll just move it up. And as you can see, I've still got it on my 25%, which is fine. I'll take it back up to 100. There we go. And of course, you can change your opacity at any time on almost any brush by just typing it in on your number keypad. There we go. Now to get rid of this arm in here, we're going to have to use some of these wrinkles in this dress. So we're going to have to come over here and being very careful in how we brush our tool. I'm just going to come in here and paint this in like so. There we go. And of course, you'll have to reset it a couple of times. I'm going to come up here and grab some of these wrinkles too. I think those would look excellent over here. There we go. Those two match up almost perfectly. Come back here and grab some of this. Of course, we'll shape this back out around as we go. But this is going to be the majority of how it's all going to be done right here. There's a lot of work here. So we're going to pause here and we'll pick this up in the next part.